Disclaimer, I am not a nail technician. Take a cuticle softener and place it all over your nail beds. And I take a cuticle pusher, cuticles push them back, and clean that invisible cuticle line. After you're done, wash your hands with soap and water. Applying tips is completely optional. Put some nail glue on my natural nail and slide the tip on, hold it there for a couple seconds, and then I apply nail glue on the top of the tip, and this just kind of helps keep that tip there in place and that you won't have any gap. Take a nail cutter and trim my tips. After applying the tips, I am going to file the tip. I'm gonna make sure I get all the shine off the tip, and also I want to kind of get the tip and my natural nail bed as even as possible. I will take step one, the Pro Base, and apply a very thin layer in a half moon shape, halfway on the tip and halfway on my natural nail, and dip it in the clear powder. After I dip, I will tap off the excess powder and use a brush to wipe off the excess powder. Apply the Pro Base to about 3/4 of my nail and dip it into the clear again. The key to doing this is always to use thin layers. After I dip it in the clear, I will tap off the excess powder and use my brush to wipe off the excess powder. And then I'm ready to do my color. So I am using the Revel Nail Aloha color here, and I did 3 coats for this mani. You can do anywhere between 2 to 4 depending on how bright or dark of a color that you want or how sheer you want it. When I apply the Pro Base, I'm gonna apply all the way my entire nail and dim tap and then brush off the excess powder. After I dip the powder, I'm gonna take the end of my cuticle pusher and really wipe around my cuticles. If you don't have a cuticle pusher with a tip like this, you could also use a toothpick. This is to make sure that the powder isn't sticking to your cuticles, and as your nails grow out, it's not going to be too thick around your cuticles and get caught in your hair. And then I'm gonna repeat the process, get as many coats as I'd like on it. After I'm done with my color, I will take step 2, which is the activator. I'm gonna apply a generous amount all over my nails and wait 2 minutes. The activator is what hardens the powder and makes it stick to your nails. So you wanna make sure you wait 2 minutes before you start filing. I'm gonna take a file and shape my nails just the way I'd like them to look. Buff all my nails, make sure that they're all as smooth as possible. I am going to rinse my hands in water, no soap, to activator again. I wait 2 minutes, wipe off with paper towel. Then I'm going to take step 3, the finishing gel. 2 to 3 quick swipes on each nail. They don't have to be perfect. Wait 15 seconds before going back and applying the second coat of finishing gel. And this is where you can take your time. In between dipping into the jar again, I like to take my brush and wipe it on the paper towel before dipping again. That way I don't contaminate my finishing gel with activator. After waiting about 2 minutes for my finishing gel to dry, I will just apply some cuticle oil and massage it into my cuticles. And that's how you do your own dip nails.